sick. What? Luchini pouring from the sky, let's get rich. What? The Jiki finds the sugar dance, can't quit. What? Now pop the cork and steam the Vega and get lit. What? 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 Introducing Phantom of the Dark, walk through my heaven with levitation from reefers, drenching deep as an E7, showboating with Rugas, flash vines.
Folks, and welcome to that channel, Skins for Life, where you just saw the most vicious headshot of many headshots you're going to see in this gameplay footage of Sniper Elite V2. I urge everybody to get this game. Now, so let you know, it is a remake of Sniper Elite from, I think, original Xbox. So this is V2, as you see. Another bullet time headshot. Bow! Right off the helmet. You see all the ricochet off the helmet, the sparks fly, and then it goes. This is a vicious game. And also let you know, I am playing it on the easiest setting so I can get these shots, because I can't get over how detailed and gruesome these sniper shots can be, especially when they get to the X-ray. Shots that go through organs. I've seen nut shots in this game. I don't know if I'm gonna be really going for those, but if I get one, that will be shown too. I've had shots where they've gone through like what the spinal column. Now I'm getting a little too graphic, but yeah, I definitely like this game. And also, those of you that definitely want to take your aggression out on the most hated man in world history, Adolf Hitler, there's a DLC that will come out that will give you the chance to hunt this man down and shoot him through the fucking head. Everybody should get this game, if not for the game itself, for that DLC alone, because I know I don't think I have any folks in my family that went through the Holocaust, but I wanted to shoot that fucker through the head too. And I want to get a chance to do it, even though not in real life, but virtually. So, another thing I want to talk about, as you see another potential sniper shot right there, is the Madden playbook that, to most folks, unexpectedly came out. Now, those that already watched the NCAA webcast already know what's going to be in Madden as far as the gameplay is concerned, so there's no need to even talk about that. The presentation for NCAA I really didn't care about, because all I cared about is gameplay, and just like Smitty, all I care about is gameplay as well. And just like Smitty, probably even more than Smitty, I'm more impressed with the presentation, the in-game presentation. What scares me is that, and hopefully they address it in the connected careers, which I think that's where they're going to talk about Dynasty, Franchise, whatever, is that franchise. I want to know what, after that gameplay and after the presentation, I want to know what they're doing with the franchise, because I did a video on the franchise mode, and it was okay for what it was, and I liked the dynamic player development, or player, or whatever it was called. I liked that feature in the game, but there was a lot that was left out. That, you know, Ian Cummings, and our whole Ian Cummings, 95% responsible for Madden 12. So Ken Weber gets like 5% of blame on that. But then again, he came in so late; they were already done with the game, so no point in really getting mad at Cam. But and this is what I want to say about how Madden is being approached this year. I know it was mostly talk how they were going to approach it, But now you're starting to see how they are approaching it. They are talking about how, okay, they doubled the team. Okay, well, they basically combined the two teams, NCAA and Madden. Okay, that's not worthy of talking about. But I like the presentation, the PowerPoint slide projections. That's a business. That's what you see in business meetings. I'd rather talk about business and have a presentation done professionally than to have some ad lib session to where I sit there and mouth off at you, big YouTube commentators, which leads to you getting let go. So Ian Cummins, that's where you failed. You couldn't do a professional job with the games, so you got let go. Enough said about that. But yeah, they're definitely a more professional approach to the game. And it matches in what they're trying to do as far as the presentation. As I get a message here on my phone. With the presentation, with adding in a professional looking broadcast in CBS. Now, I'm not an AFC guy, but I do respect the fact that they have a more professional approach to these football games than Fox. NBC is a little bit more serious. I would like to see if they incorporate the NBC type broadcast on the Sunday night games. They sat there in that webcast, they sat there and said that they would incorporate more of a difference of feel on between preseason games, which was talked about last year, and that really didn't happen. Between preseason games, Sunday night games, Monday night games, regular season. I wonder how late in the season games are going to be. So, and playoffs, and of course Super Bowl, Pro Bowl, blah, 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 blah. But there's definitely a difference. And it's one of those things where you have to sit and listen to these guys. They got two former quarterbacks working on this. Cam Weber's the GM, overall GM. But then you got Larry Reichardt, or whatever his name is. He used to play at University of Florida in the Steve Spurrier days. You got one football guy working. And then now you got this guy who used to be offensive tackle, who played in the pros, that is one of the people working on the game. That is what I was wondering about. Because I remember a video that Ian Cummings did. He did a little handheld video where he went around the office, and it's just a bunch of guys. They look like they never played football in their entire life. They had two guys that basically did the NFL blitz and whatever it was. And were in charge of gameplay. And I was just like, that's not right. They don't even look like they've played football either. So I definitely like Cam Weber's vision for both NCAA and also Madden. Like I said, the gameplay, they pretty much are streamlining the games with combining both teams. They basically are going to streamline the gameplay and probably bring back to what it used to be, that Madden would have the extra feature and NCAA would be like the demo for what Madden could do. So I'd rather have it that way and go back to when Madden was the better playing game, and I would be more excited for Madden than I would be for college. So great to see that swing go right back to where it was, because that's the way it should be. NCAA comes out first. It should be a test for Madden. That's the way it has to be. So, and then I think another thing I want to kind of speak out on is, you know, a sad and unfortunate turn of events as far as NHL hockey playoffs, not in the actual game itself, but the aftermath of Joe Ward for the Washington Capitals. Go Caps, by the way. Scoring the game winner against the Boston Bruins in Game 7, which was the most closely contested Game 7 of all time. So you had four games going to overtime, every single game, 1 through 7, one goal difference. Look at that shot right through the net. But the ugly term was that Joe Ward scores the game winner. Now those in the hockey world know that Joe Ward looks just like me. Maybe a little dark, but hey, he's African American, born in the Barbados, Canadian, raised in Canada. And I believe he played for Boston at one point. But Boston, I can name a couple of other African American players that played for Boston. Anson Carter, who was also on the Cavs at one point, that played for Boston. That used to play for Boston. They don't play for Boston currently. And I'm going to tell you why. And I think other sports African-American athletes should take note of this. But, and Mike Greer, who also used to play for the Caps, that also used to play for Boston. So what happened afterwards was that angry, there were at least 100 plus tweets or 100 plus people went on to Twitter to express their anger about the fact that Joe Ward, African-American, scored the game-winning goal against their hero, Tim Thomas, or just their team, the Boston Bruins. Now, it's not saying that every Boston fan did this, but it's saying that you have that group. You have groups of people in Boston, and from people that have lived in Boston, they can tell you better than I can. I never stepped foot in Massachusetts, so I wouldn't know. But they say that town is pretty priceless. But anyway, the tweets that came out, like I said, I'm not going to repeat. It's not even worth repeating. Pretty much know what the tweets were. It's the same type of tweets that were for Hunger Games. They found out that most of the main characters were black. So, it's just one of those things where I'm not surprised. I kind of chalk it up to typical. They were thinking it. Now they have a forum where they think they're safe. They go, and I'm glad that media outlets took these people to task. They pretty much shined a light on these people, and their accounts either were deleted or other people went to town on them. Yeah, man. But it makes it sad, because otherwise it was a greatly contested playoff series, and I'm glad the Caps won. They needed that victory. Now they got to play the Rangers, which they've been playing every year in the playoffs, it seems like. So next up for us is the Rangers. Now let's go back to Sniper Elite version 2 as we get to the end of the demo. So we got a line of trucks here, and the target's right in the middle, so that's the guy I'm trying to go after in this demo. It's just funny how this is done. I've never been able to get two of the explosives all in once, but I like this final shot here. Now, this game, don't get me wrong, I said at the beginning that I was playing it on the easiest settings, so therefore all the shots are spectacular shots. You can play it in a full realistic mode where bullet drop and wind drift and heart rate do matter. So if you want to talk about a sniper sim, this is as close to simulation as possible. Right to the guy off the truck. I was actually hoping to do that. I'm hoping to get one shot where he's jumping and I hit him as he jumps out. So, let me get another headshot here. Ooh, right through the eye, through the spine, and just destroying all that shit. But, I'm gonna get another one here too. But they don't. Ooh, right in the neck. See all that blood just spatter out, man. Ooh, right in his mouth. Oh, they call it headshot there. But, yeah, man. I would recommend everybody to get this game. This is worth buying. Again, this is the channel Skins for Life. And signing off. Peace. DC stand up.